Dear brothers, thanks for the kind encouragement at my installation as Executive Director for Spiritual Care on August 2nd. I'm eager to serve you, even as we all rejoice in Hal and Bev's wise and faithful care for us. I'm still a part-time parish pastor, too, here at Our Savior Lutheran Church, Grand Rapids, Michigan. The nave is surrounded by this depiction of the Te Deum Laudamus. Here's the noble army of martyrs. Heinrich Voss and Johann Esch were the first Lutheran martyrs. They were monks who had become Lutheran and were burned at the stake in Brussels on the 1st of July, 1523. It's appropriate that they're shown here in this Te Deum polyptych because as they were attacked by the flames, they kept singing the Te Deum until their earthly voices were no more. On July 30th, 17 years later, Robert Barnes, an Augustinian monk who had become Lutheran, was burned at the stake in England. Listen to some of Barnes' final confession. "There is none other satisfaction unto the Father but this Christ's death and passion only. That no work of man did deserve anything of God, but only Christ's passion as touching our justification. For I knowledge, the best work that ever I did is unpure and unperfect. Wherefore I trust no good work that ever I did, but only in the death of Jesus Christ." Voss and Esch's death led to the start of Luther's hymnody. He first wrote a ballad about their death, then a flood of stunning hymns boasting on our Lord's salvific work. Hearing of Robert Barnes' death, Luther wrote, "This Dr. Robert Barnes has been so graciously called by our Lord to pour out his blood and to become a holy martyr for the sake of his dear son. Let us praise and thank God. This is a blessed time for the elect saints of Christ and an unfortunate, grievous time for the devil, for blasphemers and enemies, and it is going to get even worse for them. Amen." Luther sure loves boasting in Christ's victory over Satan and the world. I need more of that. Barnes, Voss, and Esch are here as a beautiful reminder that this feeble-looking Christian church on earth is not feeble at all, not in the rich, full, saving work of Christ by the plan of the Father made yours by the work of the Holy Spirit. The same Spirit who enabled Heinrich and Johann to sing and Robert to boast in steadfast confidence in the Lord who bought them. St. Paul wrote in Romans 5, "For if while we were enemies, we were reconciled to God by the death of his Son, much more now that we are reconciled shall we be saved by his life. More than that, we also boast in God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have now received reconciliation. Not only are we poor, miserable sinners justified, declared not guilty, counted as having all righteousness, but also we're reunited with the God we've turned against. The God who loves you, who delights in you, who keeps you as the apple of his eye." No wonder Robert, Heinrich, and Johann could not be persuaded by fire to quit boasting in our Lord Jesus Christ. And the same Holy Spirit that gave them strength to endure torture and death for Christ enables you and me to bear the exhaustion of these challenging days we're in, from the pandemic to the wide-ranging, often hardened opinions of congregants, from the increased chaos in our land to the palpable hatred of Christ and his people in these gray and latter days. We're not enough for these days, but your Lord is. He is speaking to you, encouraging you personally in his strengthening word. He hears your every cry to him. He held these dear martyrs, and he holds you. And he will not let anyone snatch you out of his hand, but instead strengthens you in his peace and allows you ever to boast with joy in his eternal kingdom, which, as Luther taught us to sing, ours remaineth. Hal, Bev, and I thank God for your faithful, creative, and loving service to the sheep of our Lord's flock. You're in our prayers. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus.